Rev up your engine! Today I'm going to talk about, should you buy OEM factory car parts for your car, or can you use aftermarket parts? Now, OEM stands for Original Equipment Manufacturer. Now, of course, most of the time those are excellent parts, but they can also be sky-high prices. Now, the real OEM is the stuff that comes in the cars when they're built. Don't be confused by a bunch of companies that lie and cheat and say OEM on the box, and then there's some little thing, OEM quality. There's no real patent on OEM, so a lot of people can put the words OEM, but it doesn't mean it's the stuff that originally came with the car. Of course, if price is no object, generally buying the original equipment parts is the best thing to do. But a lot of times, hey, those prices are insanely high. Take a BMW I was working on a couple weeks ago. Need a radiator. The original equipment one from BMW was over $900. And I found an aftermarket one. Yeah, it was made in China, but it was only $140. Put it on, it worked perfectly fine. Now, I've been using these aftermarket, mainly Chinese made radiator replacements for decades now. And to tell you the truth, I've never had one come back after I put it on from problems from leaking or anything like that. They're perfectly fine. This is a Chinese made aftermarket radiator on my Celica. I got one on my Matrix. They work perfectly fine. They're just plastic with aluminum cooling fins inside. They're mass produced by machines that just crimp them on. It's not like there's a human being in there welding each thing, solder them together like they used to solder the brass and copper radiators. They're very simple technology. I've found that the aftermarket ones work perfectly fine, and you save so much money it'd be foolhardy to buy OEM. And older cars that have distributors like my Celica, hey, it's often a good idea to buy one of these brand new aftermarket assemblies. They cost a lot less. The dealer one was like $500. This thing was like $159 years ago. Still in the car, runs perfectly fine. That's a smart thing to do. But there are some times that you're much better off with OEM. And one of those is the fuel pump. I've had many customers, and they put cheaper aftermarket electric fuel pumps in their cars, especially ones that go inside the gas tank. The cars ran if they didn't run before because the pump was completely out, but they never ran just right. And I explained to them, okay, these pumps have to put a correct amount of pressure so that when the computer pulses the fuel injectors, just the perfect amount of fuel goes in. And they also have to pump the exact volume, because if they don't give enough volume, then at higher speeds, it'll hold back, won't accelerate right, or maybe we'll just go to 50, 60 miles an hour, not any further, not enough volume to keep the vehicle going at that speed. So in the case of fuel pumps, I suggest go OEM. Now let's say it's a Japanese car, and it's got a Nippondenso electric fuel pump. I'm not saying you got to go to the dealer and buy their outrageously priced ones. There's plenty of companies out there that sell the same Nippondenso pump at a lot lower price. You just want to use the same pump. You don't want some funky name company that makes pumps that says, oh yeah, you know, these are as good as OEM. Stick to OEM when it comes to fuel pumps. Sometimes things are not as simple as they seem. Sometimes the OEM parts are actually not good parts. To give you an example, go back a couple of decades, Nissan had a bunch of V6 engines with the coil-on plugs, where each particular spark plug had its own coil that was fired by a computer. These were V6, so they had 6 ignition coils. They were designed poorly. So, as they start to break down, they had to redesign the entire coil-on plug assembly, and they told people, look, when you fix this, you got to replace all 6, and you have to use these new designed ones, not the old design. For things like that, you really need to do research. You'd have to look up stuff like technical service bulletins for your vehicle, because this was a Nissan technical service bulletin. You had to replace them all 6 of them with the new designed one, or you're going to have problems. And that if you just changed a few here and there, then the other ones will start going bad and it'll never run right. So in this case, the aftermarket ones that guys made years later were actually better than the ones that originally came on the car. Now, of course, aftermarket, wide range of stuff. There's some good companies out there, like I personally have been using Dorman. It's a company that's been out there for ages. And a lot of times, their stuff is better than the original equipment. Because, let's say, you got a plastic door handle. They like the Volkswagen ones that are always breaking off. Dorman redesigned them so that they're actually stronger than the Volkswagen ones. When I put the Dorman ones on, hey, I didn't have any problems later on. Where if I use the Volkswagen original handles, a few years later, they'd break again. They have to replace them again. So you always have to do a little bit of research on that. It's not all that cut and dry with names and quality. You got to do a little research. And of course, some aftermarket products have abilities that the original equipment ones didn't. Like these multi-stage headlights that I got on my Matrix. The same headlights can be brighter, a little bit less bright, even less bright for when it's snowing, and can even be emergency flashers. You're not gonna get that out of the original equipment stuff. As things change and evolve, you can make your older car evolve too. So you can upgrade a lot of stuff that either weren't available in the beginning or cost so much money, just add it on later yourself. Like the Android radio that I put in this Matrix. The original one was a piece of crap. For around a couple $100, I put this great Android in. And the original headlights on this 07, they're ugly as can be. These aftermarket ones, hey, they're a lot cooler looking, and they're only like $69 a piece. The aftermarket's great for all kinds of stuff, especially cosmetic. And even things like air conditioning compressors. Aftermarket can be great for that. Sometimes a rebuilt factory one can be $700-$800. And that's rebuilt, not brand new. You can get aftermarket ones, sometimes as little as $200, that still have excellent quality. I have put on hundreds of Chinese made aftermarket air conditioning compressors and have had great luck with them. They've lasted for years, they bolted right on. But of course I buy them from local suppliers here in Houston that specialize in that. So they know which models are good, which models are bad. And if you take a company, say, as big as AutoZone, I know guys that are in managerial positions in AutoZone, hey, they go to China and they check out these factories. Because if they're buying all this stuff, they don't want bad quality. So they want feedback. They go over there, they talk to the factories, they see what kind of a price they can get, what kind of quality they can get. And if they find that something doesn't pan out, they'll stop selling it and they'll go somewhere else. But let's say you're an OEM fanatic and you always want the original stuff on, but you want to save money. Hey, there's always the salvage yards. There's tons of cars there to get in wrecks, especially if they were in a big wreck. Hey, they were probably going fast, which meant they were working perfectly fine as long as that part didn't get broken. There's a lot of stuff in salvage yards that are perfectly good to use if you want to stick to OEM. Heck, in the past, I used to tell customers, you know, you're probably just as well going to a salvage yard and buying a used air conditioning compressor than you are buying a rebuilt air conditioning compressor, because often the rebuilds aren't rebuilt worth beans. So back in the day, I told people, hey, why not just get a used compressor? If they don't work, they give you money back or give you another one. But I always give this one warning, and that's if it seems too good to be true, it probably isn't true. So if you find that a factory part is $700 and you can get an aftermarket one from China for $49, odds are the $49 one isn't such a hot idea to buy. And if you are buying aftermarket parts, do like I do. I mainly buy them locally, because then if I got a problem, I can take it back locally. Good luck buying something on eBay when it doesn't work right, trying to get your money back, sending it back, and then they'll send you another one. I tried that on a guy's car to save him money, and they told me I didn't know what I was talking about, that I gave him the wrong information about the car, and I said, what are you, an idiot? The hub has 4 lug nuts on it. You sent me one with 5 lug nuts. Don't tell me I'm giving you the wrong information. You guys just don't know what you're talking about. When you're dealing with people face to face, a much better situation than randomly going on the internet and hoping that something comes and works. So now you know a little bit more about original equipment factory parts versus aftermarket parts, so you can make a wise decision the next time you gotta buy car parts. And since this is Mechanic Monday, I'm going to be giving away a set of these cool Basla LED headlights that do all the flashing colors. Okay, have a chance to win. Place a clean, non-offensive comment on the YouTube comments below. And a winner will be chosen randomly at computer to get these cool multi-function LED headlights. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.